Welcome to the show. We're thrilled you could be with us today. Coming up is our friend and six-time New York Times bestselling author, Ken Abraham. But before we bring Ken out, let me introduce my mom and co-host and my friend, Sandy Hormolosa.
Hi.
How you doing, Mom?
I'm doing great.
Good. I'm excited to have Ken on the show today.
Yeah, I am too. All those books.
Yes.
We get to hear the author talk about all that he's done.
Yes, I'm very excited about that. What about you? Because we, you know, Ken was on the road. He's going to talk about that when he was younger.
And I know. Well, that's
exciting. Reminded me of our family a little bit, and just being on the road with all those kids. And
yeah,
that was a big step of faith for you guys.
We traveled without a home for about 5 years.
Really bonded us together as a family.
It really did.
You'd be surprised. I mean, it's amazing when we look back. I think in at that time in our lives, all of us, all five kids, because I'm the oldest of five children.
Right.
You have five kids. And
right.
Just the way we all feel about it, that was, I mean, I think that really helped us to be able to communicate with adults better. We were forced to.
Right.
Forced to learn how to communicate, mainly with adults, because we were with adults most of the time.
I remember telling the boys, I said, when we are in people's homes, it doesn't matter what they serve to eat, you're going to like it. And when we're finished, I told him, just move your food around on the plate, pretend you're eating, and when we're finished, if you couldn't eat it, and you really couldn't eat it, we'll go get something.
Did you give them that advice when they got married?
They married great cooks.
Yeah, they did. There's probably nothing that those girls could cook that they wouldn't like.
I know.
Well, let's introduce Ken in just a few moments when
yes.
we come back and hear from his story of being on the road and some other wonderful stories about all the authors that he's represented. So. When we come back, New York Times bestselling author of Your Best Life Now, Ken Abraham, will be with us, so don't go away. Thank you for joining us. Ken Abraham is known for his great collaborations with popular celebrities and high-profile people such as Senator Bob Dole and Chuck Norris. What some may not know is that Ken has been a professional musician and also a senior pastor. Welcome to the show today, Ken. It's so good to see you.
Great to be here.
Yes.
Good to see you,
Sandy.
Also
a dear friend.
Well, I've heard you've been having so much fun on these shows. I said, I've got to stop by and find out what's going on there.
Well, I'm so glad you did. I really am. We were talking about being on the road, and I know you had some of those days in your younger years, and before you were a famous author.
Oh, man. I spent 20 years on the road and riding around the country in the back of a bus.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, you can learn to write on the back of a bus. You know, there's not much to do in those things. You kind of go to the back, you come to the front, you're ready
right.
to go to the back.
You learn to do a lot of things.
That's for sure.
Now, what were you doing on the road and out
Believe it or not, I used to play drums.
Really?
Well, I was never any good, but I was real loud.
Most drummers
just
are.
Bang away, and I had 15 drums around me, and so you really don't have to be very good if you have 15 drums. You just got to drop the sticks, and they're bound to hit something.
No, you had to be pretty good.
No, not really. Well, but I had a lot of fun, and I smiled a lot, and so people thought I was enjoying myself, and I really was, and it was great.
How did you come to know the Lord?
Well, believe it or not, I was playing in a smoky old dance hall one
Yeah.
night.
Yeah,
wow.
And I remembered a verse of scripture that my mom had taught me as a little boy, that if any man is in Christ, he's a brand new person. Sandy, I didn't have a clue what that meant. All I knew is I was not in Christ. Whatever it was, I wasn't in.
And so you were just sitting in this, I mean, playing
No, I was playing
this,
drums.
You were playing drums.
Yeah,
you
know that.
You're kind of mindless when you're playing drums. You
yeah.
know, and I'm that way anyhow. So.
And that scripture just came to you.
It was coming to my mind. And I looked out there and I said, God, if you're real, get me out
that.
Of here.
Really?
Get me out of here. That was my prayer.
Now, how old were you?
I was probably about 18.
Oh, wow.
17, I guess. And boy, I'll tell you what, you don't pray those kind of prayers unless you really want God
That's
to
right.
answer,
no,
you know?
That's right.
Because listen, what happened, we had meticulously practiced all these songs. We'd played around all these bars and clubs in Pennsylvania and that part of the world. And we knew this material, but that night, almost instantly after I prayed that prayer, things just began to fall apart.
Oh,
we had a guitar player hit a power chord, you know, one of these, you know, little twang kind of things, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And literally, three strings on the guitar broke and came unstrung. Now, that just doesn't happen. I mean,
no.
I mean, the Rolling Stones don't have three guitar strings come off at one time, but this kid did. Meanwhile, I'm singing along. I'm playing drums, and back in those days, they would hang a boom mic down over the drummer's face, and you kind of sing right here. And you're playing over here's a cymbal here, and you're playing the snare drum here, and your feet are going on the hi-hat and the bass drum. And this microphone right here started doing all these kind of things. Start going zoop, kept going down lower. So I'm going down like one of these kind of things, trying to play.
Well, I'll tell you what, God was excited about your prayer.
He wanted me out of there. So that's what happened. By the time we took a break, we were so angry, we quit. Oh. We quit. The whole group broke up.
We definitely want to hear more, Ken, when we come back. We'll be right back with more from Ken Abraham and legal expert Carol Guest.